So the difficulty with developing any kind of algorithm is that actually the answers are not that straightforward. So for example, if you're looking at an algorithm to decide if somebody has meningitis or not, you still need clinical acumen and skills to decide if they meet certain criteria. For example, do they have neck stiffness? So even amongst a group of doctors, there may be some disagreement about whether the person has neck stiffness or not. So then just to plug that into an algorithm to say, does this person have neck stiffness, headache, photophobia, nausea, vomiting, and then pop out with a diagnosis or not, is not that helpful. So ultimately, even quite sort of complex algorithms still come down to individual skills of the practitioner that's looking after the patient.